Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video 2 and if you're having a BMW 5 Series Generation F10 from year 2010 to year 2017 and if you need to remove, replace the further valve or install aftermarket ones, Teodos will explain how to do that. There is one little bolt that is so inconvenient to get to that I was almost to the point to where I was about to remove the whole turbo exhaust manifold, the whole kit, so I can just get that bolt loose. But we found a trick how to do it. Make sure you stay with us and we'll explain about that. Before we start, let me tell you a little bit about us guys. If you need to buy new diverter valves, any parts to use for your BMW and you want to save quite a bit of money, check out the link in the description of the video below. That's where we get all our tools and supplies from. Number 2, every single car we get at the garage, we try to make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos. Why we do that guys? Simply because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need in return, please subscribe to the channel, like the video, that way we can keep making these absolutely free videos for you. Let's explain what we have specifically here. This is a 528i 2013 BMW with N20 4-cylinder 2.0 engine. So what I have done, what we have done here so far, you can see the upper engine cover, we just removed it, so we can get a little bit more room right here, because otherwise it will be a little bit sticking out. You don't have to do that, but it gives me more room, especially videoing with the camera. Another thing, I removed that metal plate shield that is right here. It has one plastic nut and one bolt over there, so that way I can actually get my head there and show you. And if you look now right here, that's the diverter valve guys. Now what I've done, around the diverter valve, right here I disconnected the hose, going to the turbo, right here from the intercooler. That's the intercooler hose. I disconnected that one. If you want to see how to disconnect the intercooler hose the right way without breaking it on BMW, we have the video on the channel. So that can give us a little bit more room. I even disconnected the other one as well, the intake hose, but I didn't have to, guys. Just ignore that part. I was about to the point that I was going to remove the turbo. That's how mad I was at that bolt. Then right here, right here is the connector, for the diverter valve. That's your connector. So all we have to do, just press, right there, press on the back side and pull it out. Here I disconnected the vacuum, the breather hose, from here to here, so I can get the tools, and I disconnected one of the vacuum lines, this one, so it can give me just a little bit more room. So you might need to do that too. I'm going to wipe all the excessive amount of oil that we have here, and probably new turbo will be needed soon, because I noticed that the car started burning a little bit of oil as well. Now in order to remove the bolts guys, let me find the bolts. That's what they look like on the diverter. You have, let me focus it. Come on, almost there. Perfect. That's the bolt, guys. That's what it looks like. You can see that bolt here. So that bolt, guys, we got those long Torx, Torx 2s. I'm going to put the link in the description of the video below where you can get them from for a really good price, guys, by the way. Those are amazing, and they're really, really convenient, and the bolts are with Torx 30. Check it out. Torx 30. Two bolts, you can easily remove those, and being long and thin, that helps a lot. The third bolt, guys, if you try the 30, it's not going to work, but that's where things can go wrong too. If you feel about that you're going to strip the bolt, don't do it. But if you get a Torx 27 for the last bolt, that is really hard to get to. It still fits pretty good, by the way. Let me focus. It still fits pretty good, but it allows me to come in an angle. Check it out. If I use this one, it will not allow me to get in an angle. Let me focus. Check it out. It doesn't go in an angle. And this one, the 27, actually, I can easily come in an angle, like that, and I can take it off. And right here now, we're going to set the camera. Let's see where the diverter is exactly. See if we can get to there. Right there. Perfect. And if I come with the two through here, guys, eventually Okay, you get on top of the bolt, okay, in an angle, and you can take it loose. And I'm going to go ahead, just remove that one, okay, we'll pull it out, and we'll show you what to do next after that. So I have it in now, guys. Okay, the tool is there, so I'm just removing the turbo now that I'm unscrewing. It's hard to show you on the camera because it's impossible to get it in there. Ah, I almost dropped the tool. So I just have very little left now. Okay, let me go ahead. Okay, remove it all the way. Okay. Yep, it's there. I'll try to remove it with the diverter. Careful not to drop it in the turbo if you removed any hoses or anything like that. I dropped the bolt. I'll get it in a second. And, oh, no, I didn't drop it. Right here, I thought I dropped it. Right here, guys, you can see, this is the bolt, okay, right here. We removed it, I didn't strip it, even though I went in an angle like that. So, that's what the diverter looks like, guys, okay, right here, that's the one, okay, right here, that's how you remove it. That's where the problem is related. We have a code, okay, especially when you drive slower or in eco mode, okay, you shift at lower RPMs, you notice that you may have a boost leak code. We'll have a special video about that. Usually when I drive it hard, it's not there, but it's because of a broken membrane, okay, on the inside. So that's how we guys remove it, okay, on a BMW 5 Series. So putting it together, guys, it's practically in reverse order. We took it apart. If you want to see how to install actually the aftermarket, okay, let me show you right here. Now we have it. Okay, the aftermarket GFB, guys, kit that will rebuild it. We'll have the video on the channel. Okay, it will be called the GFB Diverter Plus installation on BMW M20 engine. Check it out. It will teach you how to do that. If you need to buy a new one, original, I'll put the link in the description of the video below where you can get it from. Hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching and see you guys next time.